Guys, do your lips always get chapped? Yeah, that might be your fault. Hey everyone, Lisette here for DNews. Chapped lips are terrible. They're that uncomfortable dry sensation on your lips, flaky, cracky skin, and in some of the worst cases, even bleeding. They're more common in certain seasons or climates. But what causes your lips to chap in the first place? To start, the skin on your lips is much more sensitive than the skin on the rest of your body. Your lip structure is just different. While it is made up of the epidermis and dermis like the rest of your skin, the outermost layer of the epidermis, the stratum corneum, is much thinner on your lips. So thin that it allows more visibility into our blood vessels, giving our lips that reddish color. What's more, lips don't have sweat glands to provide moisture or hair to provide protection from the sun. This helps explain why lips get more chapped in the cold winter months or after catching some rays on a hot sandy beach. The excess wind, lack of moisture in the air, and UV rays can cause your lips to lose moisture, burn, and yeah, they end up being chapped. Sort of like a sunburn on your lips. But it isn't always the weather's fault. Sometimes you end up doing it to yourself. Sorry. Have you ever woken up with super dry lips, especially when you're congested? Well, this could be because you were breathing through your mouth, removing the moisture from your lips. And perhaps even worse is the act of licking your lips excessively. It may sound counterintuitive, but as the saliva evaporates from your lips, it sucks away heat and moisture with it, leaving your lips potentially drier than before you lick them. Many products we use and foods we eat can also be the culprits. These range from irritating cosmetics to toothpaste, medications, figs, food colorings, and wait for it, even lip balm. While some lip balms may be helpful, others can make chapped lips worse. I know, this one really got me too. But the problem is that ingredients in some lip balms like propylgalate or phenyl salicylate can be skin irritants. And another, salicylic acid, can cause skin to slough off more easily. Ooh! One super common lip balm ingredient that you may love is menthol. It tastes and smells delicious, but it's also an alcohol and can dry out your lips. So what can you do to restore moisture to your dry, chapped lips? Well, staying hydrated, breathing through your nose, and using a humidifier during dry months definitely helps. Not to mention avoiding licking your lips, staying away from harmful products, and reducing sun and wind exposure. But if you've just gotta have your lip balm fix, the Mayo Clinic says to try some good old petroleum jelly. But the trick here, and with anything you use for your chapped lips, is to make sure that it works for you. We all have different allergies, sensitivities, and reactions to different products, so what may work for your pout may not work for someone else's. This is a pretty common problem for people in the winter, but different seasons will affect our bodies in surprising ways. For example, did you know that winter can alter your genetics? Julia has a scoop in this video.
Those gray skies and fading evening light can have profound changes on your body. The change in light can cause problems like seasonal affective disorder, a condition which brings about a low mood as levels of sunlight-induced vitamin D drop. But there's a few other lesser-known effects of less sunlight.
Guys, do you have any science questions? What should we look into next? Tell us in the comments, subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.